Good afternoon to everyone. So as you can see, the topic of my talk is on Spintronics. All of you are basically aware of the electronics. I hope so all of you are aware. See, in electronics, what happens, the charge of electron is being considered for the storage of information. So why I have chosen the topic spintronics? Because it's spin-based electronics, in which, in addition to the electronic charge, the spin of the electron is also being considered for the storage of information. So before I come to the topic, so this is the outline of my talk. First, I will show how the technology has been evolved, and then why spintronics. Then I will tell about what is spintronics, what is the principle behind it, what are the applications, its future demand, and how it is being developed. So let me first tell you all through the journey of storage devices. The journey started with the 1920s with the idea of magnetic tape to record the audio. Then 1930s magnetic drums and so on. Then the concept of hard disk came in 1956. I think all of you are aware of this music tape, which was first came into picture by Philips. Then concept of floppy in 1971 by IBM. Then CD. CD के पीछे क्या लॉजिक था कि पहले जब ये 1980s में आया, इसमें हम लोग एक बार डाटा स्टोर कर सकते थे, डाटा को रीराइट नहीं कर सकते थे. Then the situation changed after this when the rewritable data came into picture. Then the CD rewritable means you can write the data and then erase the data. Then the concept of flash memory. So all of these are storage devices. And now today the technology of cloud storage, I think we have heard the topic of Dr. Sarkar. So have you ever wondered how many pictures or videos can you store in your computer? And how many books? I think the whole encyclopedia that you can store in a only few GB pen drive. Yeah, this is the scenario. In 1975, the first portable laptop that came into picture was a CRT display with 2 megahertz processor speed and 64 KB of RAM. So you see how the technology has evolved. In 2018, the laptop is used with of LED display, which runs on the processor of 4 gigahertz and up to 16 GB of RAM. So nearly 2,000 times the speed has changed. And now Dell is in the process to keep the RAM up to 192 GB. So how all this is possible? The question is, how this is possible? And again the question arises, the technology has evolved 2,000 times. So there was a famous quote कि जिस हिसाब से technology बढ़ी है, अगर उस हिसाब से हमारी कार की speed बढ़ी होती, तो हम लोग few minutes में पूरे globe का 3-4 बार चक्कर लगा लेते. You can see with 1.9 megahertz, so now we are running in gigahertz. So can anyone guess what is this? This is the first hard disk drive of 5 MB. This was a hard disk. It was of refrigerator size and its weight was few tons. And it was being carried like this. So today a portable hard drive that fits in your pocket can hold up to 2 TB, which is 4 million times more than the first hard drive. So such time the technology has evolved. So electronics has produced an amazing revolution. So now the question is, how is it possible to store all that information in such a small space? So if you look at this graph, this is Moore's law, which tells us with the evolution of technology, the number of transistors are being more and more, means increasing. You can see in 1970s, only 1,000 transistors were on a chip. But as the technology, as the years are passing by, in 2016, you can see there are 200 million transistors on a single chip. So with such many transistors on a single chip, What are the problems? The problem is the scorching heat problem. Means the circuit will heat up. And as you reduce the size, then the quantum phenomena will take place. Means the quantum effect is like when you reduce the size and it comes to the size of Bohr radius. Bohr radius is around half angstrom. So there the role of spin comes into the picture, like electron. So when spin and the electronics is combined, so it will come to spintronics. So what is spin? As you can see, is the sun and earth. So earth revolves around the sun and it also rotates around its axis. Similar is the case of electron. Electrons also revolves around the nucleus and also rotates around its axis. So with this, it possesses two types of spin. One is spin up and another is spin down. So you can take it spin up either one state or spin down at zero state. So all the information which are being stored in a system, that is in the digital information 0 and 1. So now the concept of resistance comes into picture. Because the theory came into the picture with the evolution of GMR effect. So what is the giant magneto resistance? It is the change of resistance in the magnetic field. So if the change of resistance is very high, then it names it giant. So first of all, it was discovered by two scientists, Albert Fert and Peter Grunberg. They are all from one French scientist and one German scientist. And for this GMR effect, they were awarded Nobel Prize in Physics in 2007, in which they have studied a system of layered system, means channel system, one layer, top layer, one layer, top layer. So the system was like this. So the advantage of spintronics is the low power consumption, less heat dissipation, its memory is non-volatile, takes up lesser space on chip and thus more compact. As you can see, if you switch off the computer, the data is still there. So spin manipulation is quite faster, so greater read and write speed. So these are the basic features in which I am working basically. I am working with the ferromagnetic metals with the non-magnetic semiconductor like silicon, germanium, or some other non-magnetic substrates. So these are the area in which I am working. So I will show you this picture in which you will come to know how a hard disk works. So keep an eye on this, the tip of this needle, how it is composed of. You see, this is a layer, it's a magnetic layer. When it passes through the bits, magnetic bits like this yellow one, it senses a signal. When it is a single layer, it senses a signal like this, means the resistance is quite small. But when it is composed of alternating layers, what you will see, you see, when it is composed of many layers, the signal has quite enhanced, means the sensing speed is quite enlarged. So this is the basic phenomenon of spintronics, in which the sensing capability is quite enhanced if you take multiple layers. And most of the signals, the spin orientations are quite blocked here, and only one channel of spins is allowed here. So it's quite high sensing speed. So because of the higher speed and reduced power consumption, I think the future era will be of spintronics. Thank you. And by the end, I will talk about the electron is not as simple as it looks. Thank you all.